Progress are at the top of their game, shattering world records again and again in Sunwell Plateau speedruns. And these are actually getting way more hype and way more exciting, as Progress took a new world record last week, and then this week, TNB and Noobs, Horde, and Alliance both went in and actually fully cut off multiple minutes from that time. Well, Progress responded today by cutting off another 3 minutes, ending up with 34 minutes and 50 seconds Sunwell Plateau speedruns. This is not even a perfect run, so we're going to see things even faster coming soon. So the competition is hot. Hopefully, Blizzard will employ some sort of speedrun meta in official servers or tournament realms in the future for Wrath of the Lich King, especially with buffed Naxx. But before we get into the run, I do want to show you guys one strategy that they did before the raid that I've been trying to kind of get people to kind of hop onto, and that is gonna be to actually pre-summon the imps. So you trigger this pull right here, and you pre-summon these imps, and then you bring them all over to the rest of the raid. So you can actually MC them when you actually start the raid. You can just banish them for now, and all of your warlocks can have an imp as you start the actual raid. This actually gave Progress an extra 2,400-ish DPS overall for the section that they had these imps. So the beginning of the raid is also the most challenging. Anyways, guys, let's dive right in, and congrats again to Progress. We're gonna watch Stade's POV, which is him absolutely pumping and getting rank 1 Hunter. Paladin bubble pulled. Instantly moved over here. Stade is already... he's not going to melee wave on trash just to be safe, which makes a lot of sense. One fiend already broke. They're just going to re-grab that most likely. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 warlocks. Let me move myself. There. There we go, guys. There I am. And let me get that working. All right, good luck to Progress. Good luck to Progress. Good luck to Progress. They have the Pat walking away right now, it looked like, I think. I didn't see it load in. They're gonna get an MD Sapper, Juicy, and then they're gonna pull this next Protector. It looked like the Pat was walking away. It might have been a scout walking away. On overall damage right now, Xander and Weasel are pumping everyone else. Warlock's really juicing up these first few pulls. Yeah, I clipped it. Pre-summoning the imps. It's a strat that I've been pushing for, you know? It's pre-summoning imps, so all of your... look at all of their warlocks have these imps that hit for like a 2,000 damage AoE on like a 6-second pull. Yeah. It's a great... I just literally, as I was talking about it and trying to clip it, right as they were doing it, I got tagged like in Discord instantly. Clean... I don't know where their Pat is. Again, they're two tanking. Windforce and Creditor are basically doing all of the tanking for them. This is the scary pull, so your heroism. This is the pull that you'll see the second heroism sent out. This is easily probably the scariest pull in the beginning of the instance. There are generally two Vindicators in this pull, and those are the guys that can cleave and smack. That's a scary pull. They also got a distract from Xeratu so that their patrol is timed better. They'll kill his patrol, as well as I think they should grab a protector. I think they have one left. I wasn't counting 100%, but I think they skipped that one inside so that they could grab a protector here. Let's see. It looks like they're not. It looks like they're not grabbing a protector. So they're just gonna go directly into this pull. No extra protector. So I guess they did get all of the protectors they need. Actually, no, they're going and grabbing it now. I don't know what the point of doing that would be. Because they could have had the protector at half HP from like a cleave on 4 targets during the pat. And it's just less
random damage. Although they're pretty good at mitigating damage, they are taking quite a bit of raid damage here. The Protector still does die at pretty much the same time as the rest of the pull, so it's not like it really slowed them down realistically. I think it could have been slightly cleaner. And you can also see, by the way, all of the buffs up. Even the XP buff, because State is like, I'm a pump and get it all. Juiced up. I believe State just tossed on a necklace. I don't know what this is right here. I can't tell. We're going to see. They might be... Pendant. That might be a pendant. Yeah. It looks like they're equipping it beforehand. And popped. There we go. Popped in and moving on. So this is actually really clean using the arcane necks. On trash using multiple necks. That means they're probably also going to use fire necks pretty often, especially for twins, which is just a lot of extra damage for the whole raid to mitigate. Especially if they're running lower on healers. I'm not sure if they're live logging this, but 1, 2, 3, 4 healers here, 5. I believe they're 5 healing. With a full boomkin. Yeah, they're running with a full boomkin. Their warlocks get juiced up, realistically. Progress's warlocks get like the most juice out of any warlocks ever. It's awesome. Because they've got Toto, who's playing on Ellie also. This is where I think the first rocket boots should be used. Every time, pretty much. I think the first rocket boots would be used there, and you could keep drink walking. So I'm not sure why Progress opted not to, although they don't have boots on anyways, right? So they don't have boots on. They're gonna mount up here after this next pull. So you're gonna chain pull this. Stridum, if you're watching, this is an important pull to bring in. Very important pull to bring in. Because we're going to mount up all the way to the boss from here. Everything else is pre-cleared all the way to Brutalis, guys. Everything else is fully pre-cleared all the way up to Brutalis. Cabalus are the only mobs that don't really move, so range have to turn around and kill those, while warriors can usually cleave off and just murder the rest of everything. That's not a good word, but, you know, destroy it. Now they're going to mount up. Change gear, he puts back on his clutch. Re-equips his juicy like Naru sliver, which we decided not to give to Sarth. Actually, now I should have taken it, huh? Why was I not a goblin? I think they got a soothe up on boss so they can move in time. It doesn't actually look like it has a debuff of soothe, but he kind of got pretty close to it. Getting teleported first is scary. Getting teleported first is scary, guys. Threat is super intimidating, so that's why he's not opening up on DPS. Because he might, yeah. Getting teleported first means, like, literally, like, you'll over-aggro Kelikos. Literally, you'll over-aggro Kelikos if you don't, because you don't have a tank here yet, right? So you can't really be pumping. There's the Fane, and I didn't see a resist notification, so I think he's good. Yeah. Yo, Crazy Eyes. Yeah, appreciate that, man. Hope you're loving weaving. It is the most fun playstyle ever. And there's a Windfury totem. Now he's gonna pump up on DPS. State is about to do insane amounts of damage now. Although he did use 2 minutes. So he's back up top, get in range, and just start weaving. No Hunter's Mark on boss. No Hunter's Mark. I don't know why State isn't just throwing one up for himself. Yeah. It is up? Oh, yeah, it's up right there. You're right. Yeah. God, it's a trip seeing where people have different like things they're tracking. You know? Sunder's here. Oh, is this the ones missing? Because you don't see Curse of Wreck up there. I wonder what he's tracking. That might be what's missing. Mount up and run all the way to the boss. Yeah. Now they're mounting, running directly to Brutalis. Brutalis. Last week, we're seeing noobs, hunters were both doing 3.8k almost DPS on Brutalis this week. They did have one lust. It looks like they're going to fight Brutalis right from here instead of running around. I kind of like this strategy, although it doesn't necessarily really save much time because they had to wait either way, right? So it's not like it's much of a time save. And I think Stade is going to be in full-time melee weave mode where he's not even, like, in a ranged group. Let's see. First burn on the Glaive Rogue. Xair 2 pumping the damage. Stade CDs are up and ready. I'm not sure if they're going to use a heroism, so we're going to find out if he's holding for that. But he does have 2-minute CDs. He doesn't have... There is the heroism. He doesn't have rapid fire. Gets the feign off. Sort of waiting for, maybe fully waiting for rapid fire, although. Yeah, no, it's he totally can wait for rapid fire. He has 20 seconds left of heroism. He's at 3.5k and about to pop CDs. That is super unfortunate. But now he's about to pop off on meters, right? Yeah, oh man. Juiced up. 4.2k. There you go, dude. Yeah, so they're going to have more lusts for Felmis. Where? Yeah, 3 lusts here. 4 lusts ready for Felmis. They're obviously going to 1 phase, 1 air phase Felmis. They also oh, sent...
Shit. I'm trying to get your attention.
Oh, is that his follow notice or something? Is Stade best hunter in the world? He's one of them. He is incredibly good. Definitely up there. Yeah. The experience buff coming in clutch, dude. Realistically, with my MS delay playing on EU, he would beat me if we were one-on-one every time. Weaving on NA is infinitely smoother. Isn't he just pressing a macro and fight? He's not using the melee weave macro. He's moving. Although technically people that use like the button things right here that are detecting key presses, technically this wouldn't change if you were using the mouse macro. Technically this wouldn't change at all if you were using the mouse macro, because the mouse macro would input keyboard commands. So it wouldn't like be able to detect. Beastial again, 4.1k from Stade. 4.1k, 1 Bloodlust, juiced DPS. All right. There we go. The macro actually does make you go into range mistakes also, by the way. The melee weave macro every now and then eventually moves you slightly too far in, eventually. So you have to readjust, which takes like a second, but everyone does that anyways. All right. 13 minutes, 20 seconds. Let's see. Yeah, that's a pretty nutty performance right there. I think Noda is...
Yeah, oh my god, phenomenal. Did you just give me a sub to Stade? While I wasn't paying attention?
Oh my god. Oh, it's fucking pumping, dude. Multi-shot on cooldown when you melee wave. Looks like you didn't use it often. You kind of rarely-ish use it. Rarely. Yo, everyone, welcome to the stream from Jordy's stream. We are watching the progress world... Not world run, world record yet. But progress go for their speed run right now. Yeah. There's a Chinese hunter who did 4.5k DPS. Yeah, I think it's top two at the 4.1. It's hard to beat the Chinese with... at all right now. It's hard to get a rank one at all right now. Now that we're this late into the phase, yeah. Also, yeah, steady shot with Thordahl is the giga. Oh, they're using the cart strat. They're using the cart strat. This is sketchy. This can be sketchy. Sorry, reload. Okay. Stayed with a 5.1k opener. Did they have no heroism even, right? Oh, no, it is up. It is up. All right. I always forget how to look at heroism. Stayed giga pumping. This is why I think hunters on single target are just so fucking powerful. They are. They're realistically so strong. You know? Do hunters still melee weave, multi-shot, arcane shot if they're not... if they're not melee weaving, yes, you do. You still have to go 5-5-1-1 quite often. Yes. 41% currently. Now they're all going to jump up on the cart after they move. That was... See? So now they're using cart strats so their melee can all DPS the boss. And then they're running away when the beams are about to go out. New beam goes out, and then they're back up. Really, really clean from progress there. Noda realistically... had four people die on this using the cart strat because one melee got targeted with the beams. Really, really, really clean. 31%. Fucking smooth. Progress is... They're just top tier. I love it. I love it. Like, watching them is just always so clean. Always so smooth. So far, Stade's had to use three fell mana pots. Do you realistically, or did they, question mark, I don't know if you know how to use that word. What do you mean? I guess I don't know what I, if I, like, word vomited. Yeah. Watch them die to breath. Oh my god. Oh, go down, run! I don't know why Stade didn't swap to, oh, does get a shot off. A little cheeky. And back into weaving. They're gonna have hunters or warriors, paladins, sorry, use DIs. Again, if anyone gets like encapsulated, they're basically gonna instantly DI. They're bringing Thelmist over closer to the exit, which is really clean, so you can leave faster. Then they'll probably equip Rocket Boots. They'll have, hopefully, a Priest Mass Dispel to insta-pull the first group here, and then Eplios will send his pet to pull the next group. So you can see that the Shadow Priest is already getting into position. And so is Kia. Shadow Priest is going to Mass Dispel right now. MD gone, and you're going to see the Owl go through most light. Oh! You can actually MD pull that one too. I did not know that actually. That is beautiful. So they were a two mass spell pulls there. We're stealing that, you know? Yeah? full mount and see how far they can get. MD Sapper probably coming right now. Yep, there we go. Okay. Nothing else too crazy there. But they did get up pretty quickly. They're actually doing this section fast. They'll probably go... It didn't look like they equipped rocket boots, but I'm not sure. Yeah, he doesn't have boots on here. I'm not sure why they wouldn't want to boot up here. It's not much time. I mean, they have to wait anyways. They had to wait there for Windforce to get a shield out. And since they're running two tanks, it's probably smoother to not rocket boot. Yeah, would you recommend engineering for Hunter for the rest of TBC? Yeah, engineering's best forever. Engineering is like the best profession for everyone, always, throughout all versions of Classic. Get it right now before it's more expensive to level because everyone's leveling it for Wrath. You should just buy a kit. Buy a kit. Every single raider in Wrath is going to want engineering, right? Everyone gets rocket boots. Everyone has sappers. Everyone gets haste to gloves. It's a second trinket. If you're on Benediction NA Alliance, if you message a guy named Canary, he can give you a kit. I know he sells them at discounted rates. If you message Canary and just say I sent you, he'll give you a discount. I don't know who has full profession kits on Gannis. What about a Blizzard nerfs engineering? Hashtag some changes. That would be pretty lame. Like the nerf to leatherworking was a cool one, right? Now you don't all need to be chain popping, right? Yes, Iguana. I'm Alliance on how much are the kits? I don't know. I just know there's a discount. I don't know if Canary's here. There. We just pinged him. Yeah, Stride, you make so many engineering bots, dude. You could for sure do it. Our Baker's doing some renovation in the roster. That is ideal, yes. Percentage food to get mana fast. Sade's also not weaving on this fight, and I think we have to suggest that in my run, my hunters don't weave phase one. It's just safer, especially now that we're running more melee. We can't let hunters weave phase one. It's just safer. Also, he's rocking a cloaking device. A lot of people are choosing to run PvP trinkets. A cloaking device literally does everything the PvP trinket does, but better. You take no damage, it instantly drops the cast of the conflagration. There's no point whatsoever to use a PvP trinket over a cloaking device. Right? Just use cloaking device. They're at 22 minutes. I don't have the current world record pulled up, but I can. So we can track time. And then you're going to melee weave the second phase. Yeah, Twins is a fight that literally kills my guild every week. That's not even a joke. My guild can't kill Twins. Current world record is 26 minutes, 17 seconds on Twins kill. They're ahead. It's 20 defense or whatever. It's defense.
They're ahead. They're very much ahead. When a Rapid Strike, I don't see any cooldowns anywhere.
He's going off of all melees. He's not just using Rapid Strike. He's going off of all melees. Yeah. A lot of fire debuffs. Yeah, there is. I'm curious why they didn't wait, but I'm guessing they're choosing to heal through it. What? The only high people are Marco and Chairlock. Everyone else is like pretty low, but that's a lot of damage. Realistically, Marco and Chairlock might need to die. Legal Mind getting low, Creditor getting low. Wind Force is dead. That was sketchy. Creditor just AoE taunted and basically probably saved everyone. He's fine. Am I about to get solo boosted? Let's go. Yeah, exactly. That's why I'm like, I don't think, how did progress not, they had it last week. They had record last week. Do they somehow beat their Maru? Their Maru was insane. But I think noobs tied it yesterday. Let's see. Their Maru last week was fun. Was so crazy. Speed. Yeah, noobs tied it, 156. Yeah. Apart from the common, this is hit buff. This is defense. Hit defense. This is crit buff right here. He's running Black and Naru Sliver. This is crit buff. This is Drain Eye buff, because that's a pretty cool buff. I'm surprised they didn't renew this buff for stamina, but it is what it is. They're bootsing in to Maru. I really like the boots into Maru himself for melee. You just have to make sure you switch boots insta. And they will one phase Maru for sure. They're just going ham. Yeah. I mean, the difference between Horde Alliance buffs are extremely small. Darkness. They're literally getting it before the darkness, basically. It's so fast. They actually might have it faster than their last time. This might be like 2 seconds faster. Let me see. Name. Nasty Blast. Wee woo! He's just getting hunted. Dispel this fucker. Oh my god. That's a hilarious weak aura. Alright, Sunglow Vest. Alright. Drink Walk all the way. Aspect of the pack, of course. Of course, of course. 152. That was insane. That was insane. So now Fienzi's looking to take world number one. Fienzi's looking to take world number one on overall damage again. I like to see on the log how much damage they got from those imps at the beginning, because that's so much damage added up. Is he Tauren? People are using Tauren debuff, the transporters from engineering, right? They're just using transporter from engineering. Has anyone died? Windforce was the only one I saw die. Did they heal Marco through his debuff the entire time? Because they did so much damage on Maru, they never had to worry about raid healing. I didn't even notice that. That literally went through, dude. Died twice, once on Felmus, once after Twins. Oh, the DI. The DIs. But do those really count as, like, deaths? I guess so. Yeah. Nick the Shaman died on Maru. Okay. So yes, not a perfect execution, but damn close. It's over. It's over. This is insane. Yeah. Timer's right here. 31:11. They are on fire, Jordy. They are on absolute fire right now. And it's Warlock adds, RIP. Actually, that's pretty good. You can move them. You can move Warlock adds. So the Warriors will get a lot of cleave off them. You can see Fienzi as his little Tauren guy right here is going to get a crazy boost here. Bloodlust just came off CD, I would assume. Nyx is off CD now too. They're going to send it whenever they can. They're going to get their first Dragon Orb soon. But they're already at 3.7k, 3.8k DPS, right? Without even a Dragon Orb, and they just got a Bloodlust. If I understand it correctly, he doesn't do Raptor just... He does Raptor and White. You do every melee, which includes Raptors, right? A little bit sketchy. There's a death from a pet. It's just a pet dead. Okay. That one person had the flame darts on him because he didn't get buff and got fire bloom. Fienzi with fire bloom got a little low there for a second. Now we're back up. Windforce picks up these enhancement shaman mobs and probably drags them in. I would assume the melee group is going to move over to the left a little bit. At least Fienzi did. The Warriors do want to get some cleave off on these ones. All right, they did. There's probably a call to move them over there and get breathed on also. Next Dragon Orb is going to be activated. It's going to do a breath and then probably cancel it, or someone else is going to grab. Or he's just going to wait until it gets broken. Let's see. Yeah. They haven't even had a darkness, yeah. Not one yet. And they're gonna skip it again. And there's gonna be these last ads. Everyone's gonna just basically ignore these last ads. The whole next point of this is to just kill. Literally, this first dragon has lasted the whole time. They still have a void spawn, yep. Sada's trying to get breath on. Yeah, he missed it slightly. Unfortunate. There's a full breath. And it's done, dude. Oh my god. Sub 35 if they get this right now. And there it is. Mm.